Lecturer at the University of British Columbia and Royal History Expert Dr. Sarika Bose spoke to Express. Co.uk about the perceptions of the royal family in Canada and how the interview with Oprah Winfrey affected the Commonwealth country's view on them. Dr. Bose explained many Canadians were unsure of Meghan Markle and have yet to make up their minds about her, as she said the interview made many Canadians step back and think more widely about the royal family. But she added many Canadians would actually like to see Prince Harry and William reunite, as there was a positive response to their statue unveiling of Princess Diana, and hoped they could do more things in the future. Speaking to Express.co.uk, Dr. Bose was asked how Canadians took to the Oprah Winfrey interview and revealed many Canadians were fairly apathetic to the royal family. She explained because of the difficulty of removing the Queen as head of state, many Canadians simply tolerate the royal family, and explained that is one reason why Republican campaigns have struggled to take over. However, she said many still have a personal view of the royal family, which is tied more to personality rather than anything constitutional. She added, "I don't think the interview has damaged that relationship with the royal family. I think people listened a little bit to some of the evidence and information that came out of that interview and perhaps took a step back. I think the Queen is as popular as any member of the royal family, and I think there was a great deal of sympathy when Prince Philip died and the funeral was televised here. People looked at all of the body language, as it were, and the events, and also with the statue unveiling. I think that there is a general sentiment that it would be good if the brothers reunited. I think that when it comes to the Duchess of Sussex, it's a little bit hard to tell because people aren't quite sure what to make of her." Dr. Bose also explained Americans backed Harry and Meghan because they represent celebrity rather than royalty, which could bring up the historic problems the US has had with the royal family. She explained, "There's a sort of glamour and a mystique from the royal family, and having members of the royal family living can be a little bit of a lift for many people. And they do have a celebrity status there, which perhaps works very well in that context. I keep thinking of the Duke and Duchess of Windsor a couple of generations before, and they seem to have very similar status. That they were this glamorous couple that went to the best parties and so on. Now the upper classes in America are very much connected with the celebrity status." Senior fellow of the Bow Group think tank, Lee Cohen, warned, however, that American audiences could accept Prince Harry and Meghan, but not when they waded into political debates. Mr. Cohen referred to Prince Harry's appearance on the Armchair Expert podcast, where he branded the First Amendment bonkers. The Duke of Sussex told the podcast, "I've got so much I want to say about the First Amendment as I sort of understand it, but it is bonkers. I don't want to start going down the First Amendment route because that's a huge subject and one which I don't understand because I've only been here a short time." Mr. Cohen agreed there were many who could back the Sussexes if they stayed out of politics, which is especially sensitive considering the royal family history with America, but their decisions to make comments on the US would turn people away from them. Related articles: Queen sends royal fans in frenzy as hilarious clip unearthed on TikTok. Prince Harry and William reunion chants emerges to fight satire show. Queen's brand greater than Nike and Ferrari in big royal family win.